You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. You'd be like heaven to touch. I wanna hold you so much. At long last, love has arrived, and I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you.
Pardon the way that I stare. There's nothing else to compare. The sight of you leaves me weak. There are no words left to speak. But if you feel like I feel, please let me know that it's real. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you.
Trust in me when I say,
oh my God, you're oh, baby, that's really good to know.
Baby, don't bring me down, I'll pray, baby. Now that I've found you, stay and let me love you, baby.
Are they still crying still?
Oh yeah, we all are.
You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. You'd be like heaven to touch. I wanna hold you so much. At long last, love has arrived, and I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. Trust in me when I say, oh, pretty baby, don't bring me down, I pray, oh, pretty baby, now that I found you, stay and let me love you, baby, let me love you.
Jonathan, will you take Georgina to be your wife? Wait for it.
Oh.
You might not agree in a minute. Will you love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all of us, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Glad to hear you still agree.
I, Georgina.
Take you, Jonathan.
To
be my husband. To have and to hold. From this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Till death us do part. According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God.
I make this vow. There we go, and that's it. You are married. So this is a big round.
Love never fails, but where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away.
Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom,
power and glory,
forever and ever.
Amen.
Guest speaker for the next 90 minutes. My chosen subject will be the trials and tribulations of Newcastle United in the modern era.
This
is probably like one of the first few times that me and Joey like hung out. And we were playing this game, and we were just having a few drinks, playing FIFA, it's all good. And somehow, Johnny got so drunk. So drunk. And if you know Johnny, that's a rarity, a real rarity. And I don't know how, but he was still winning. Like he was like on the controller, not even looking at the screen, scoring. And I'm like, what is going on here? And I was like, you know what, I like this guy.
So many of you know Gina loves Disney, and in particular she loves the Disney princesses. Her favourite princess is the Princess Aurora from the story Sleeping Beauty. In preparation for this speech, I read the story and found that the Princess Aurora was visited by 7 fairies who each gave a gift that Gina has. The first fairy gave the gift of beauty, the second fairy the gift of virtue, the third fairy the temper of an angel, and the fourth fairy the singing voice of an... She wasn't visited by all the fairies, but a good few of them turned up. And at age 11, she was visited by this fairy, who gave...
Black cardigan. What's going on?
But what an emotional day. And, you know,
what can I say? Georgina and I, we are very, very close. Don't look at me, I'm going to stop crying. It's been really hard. I've given her away. I'm not even a very generous person.
I'd like to say thank you, all four of you. Firstly, for not disowning me when I brought back a southern act. But mainly for your unwavering support and guidance. Everything good that I have in me, I learned from you. Everything I have that's bad in me also, I learned from you. But if you want to, Gina, I can tell you later which one's which. Gina's family, you all welcomed me from the start, even if you didn't understand what I was saying most of the time. I very much appreciate it.
I don't really need to say much in this speech. I feel that 10 Hindus really does show you how amazing you are, Gina. Even though our story started where I wasn't actually meant to be at yours and Johnny's birthday 4 years ago, it's safe to say what an incredible friendship it's turned out to be and how lucky my family is to have you in our lives. But there's a few people that couldn't attend, which is great for Johnny and Gina because they often see my children naked all the time, so it's fantastic for today. But they wanted to tell you both how special you are and wish you a life of happiness and fun for the future. Don't stop, please, God, don't stop. So here's a special message from Isaac, Lewis, Maisie, Tommy, Rory, Nelly, Arthur, Jude, and of course the new addition, Sienna. Let's hope it works.
The date is the 20th of November 2016, and I get a message off Johnny. Johnny, date's going well. Me, that's good. Was going to ask, but didn't want to interrupt. Johnny, I just dropped off.
Ha ha.
Johnny, Johnny, 7 pints later. Me, nicely done, lots of drinks. Johnny, just chatted the whole time. First kiss in the taxi. Standard.
So, my express heartfelt gratitude to all of our friends, everybody for coming down. It just shows how popular Georgina and Johnny are. And I know some people have made exceptional journeys on planes flying across the Atlantic and further away, I understand as well. So thank you very much for all coming. Absolutely grateful.
You and me at the breakfast table, barely awake, I let precious time go by. Then when she's gone, there's that surge of that melancholy feeling and a sense of guilt I can't deny. What happened to those wonderful adventures? The plans that I had for us to go? Well, some we did, but most we didn't. And why? I just don't know.
Yes. I knew myself and Johnny were destined to be best friends. And it was 14th of February 2013, Valentine's Day, when we made romantic plans to go to Witherspoon's curry night. Johnny, being the typical romantic, even bought me a card. It was then off to watch the best club of the Premier League play under the lights of the Europa League. Soon to be next season. It wasn't the best game of football, but we had plenty of laughs, and even an everlasting injury to Jonathan's kneecap after I lost my temper and smashed a seat under it, which he still hasn't gotten over. It reminds me every time it's acted up.
I remember seeing Gina at school for the first time. She was beautiful, she was funny. She just reminded me of Buffy from the show. And I really wanted to be friends with Buffy. She kicked ass. She was the girl to know. And I'm sure it's not a surprise to anyone here. She brought the best out in people. It did help that her mum would let us drink at her house. That's not a surprise to anyone here as well.
Please do it. Embrace every opportunity, live every adventure, and enjoy life, because it will fly by. Life will slip through your fingers before you know it.
Anyone who's met Gina knows how strong-willed she is, how determined she is. Always focused on what she wants to do. Her preparation and dedication transcends just her business into all aspects of her life. She's totally devoted to whatever she's doing, whatever she puts her mind to. She's strong-willed and determined to succeed. Whether that being a coaching, a podcast, becoming an IFBB national champion, or even on holiday in Fort Ventura, when she decided to want to use a local toilet. To which I said, I don't think you want to do that, and she was again equally as determined, headstrong, clear-minded, and went, no, I do want to do that. Then proceeded to go to men's toilets, which then came out to a massive queue of men, and then blamed me.
There was a follow-up date on the Wednesday. Nice to have the option to see someone so easily. Plus, they being keen is good. Exploring Dawson too. Me, get you off the ship. Spend time with a nice lady. Johnny, she's hot too. Great body.
True.
Johnny, better legs than me. Awkward.
Still.
Yeah. Aye, some things don't change. Aye.
I see how supportive you are of each other in every instance, and that is so important. Johnny, I couldn't be happier for the fact that you have chosen Georgina to be your wife. You are such a lovely young man, and I am so proud to welcome you into our family.
I love you! Happy wedding day, Georgina and Johnny, to Wolfie.
Jonathan and Gina, have a fantastic wedding, Lord.
Happy wedding day!
Happy wedding day. Congratulations. Have an amazing day. You guys are perfect together. From Maisie.
Congratulations, Gina and Johnny, for your wedding. We love you.
So cute. Okay, I got you.
Hi, Jonathan and Gina. Congratulations. I hope you have a wonderful day. Lots of love, Maisie and Tommy.
Sienna?
Yes.
Fine.
Couldn't
miss him
out.
No.
Oh. Love you. Oh.
There you go.
Then on Christmas Day, I met Johnny for the first time. And he was all the wonderful things that she said, but I knew he was a keeper when I read the news that George Michael had died of pneumonia, and Johnny said, I guess he couldn't wham himself up.
I used to stand and go, Kiwi, Georgina! And then, she'd be playing on the other side of the field.
We've got a bit of a routine, actually. So, on Christmas Day, Georgina and I, we walk the dogs, we go and have a mulled wine, we go and watch the swim, we come home, we cook our Christmas dinner, and we eat it, and then we play games, and then we open our Christmas presents. On this particular Christmas Day, which was the first one that Johnny came to stay with me, I have never done anything so quickly. We ran the dogs, we gulped the wine, we rushed through the Christmas dinner, because she had to get to that ship to go and pick him up and bring him back for Christmas. There was something there that really was magical. And when he came back and you were there as well, Mirrors, we had a wonderful afternoon. He drank all my vodka.
From the first time I met Jean, I could see what Joy saw in her. I knew that this was the end for me and him. He replaced me with something younger and hotter. And I couldn't blame him. So to the happy couple, yeah. Jonathan Jean.
He had all the great northern traits. He's trustworthy, supportive, loyal, and always outspoken when needed to be to look after my best interests. These are some of the great northern traits that make a great best friend, but also, no doubt, will make a great husband. He is the real deal.
Oh. So, I'd like to raise a toast to Denise, Peter, Paul and Carol and say thank you for bringing all of you into our lives through Johnny.
Hip hip! Are served in the other room and the party's just beginning.
This will be an everlasting love. This will be the one I've waited for. Love.
dreamed of, and no one, no one could take the place that you know. This will be an everlasting love. This will be the one I've waited for. This will be the first time anyone has been me. I'm so glad you found me in time. I'm so glad you rectified my mind.
As long as I live.